This video is for the second step in the making graphs assignment. This is where we're actually going to start making a graph. So in this video, we need to talk about how to actually make the computer do all the work for us. There are two different types of graphs that we need to make. The first one is a trials graph, and the second one is an averages graph. If you prefer to read the instructions for how to do this, you can open this link in the sheet that you're working on, or just keep watching this video. First thing we're going to do is highlight the cells that we want the computer to use when we make our graph. We're just making a graph of the trials, so we're not going to highlight this averages column. I've just done all my soaps and three trials. Then we go to Insert, and we're going to choose Chart. Once it works its way around, it pops a chart up, and you might think, all right, we are totally done, but there are still more things that we need to do to this. So the first thing that we have to do is make sure that Google has chosen the correct graph for us. Sometimes it does, sometimes it doesn't. So in this case, our independent variable was the type of soap. Since that is qualitative, that's going to give us a bar graph. And it looks like Google chose the right thing, so that's good. The next thing that we're going to do is give it a title. So right now it thinks this is the title, but that's no good. A decent title is something that tells us the IV and the DV. So this might be type of soap versus, this was bubble size. I'm actually just stealing the same title that was on the table, which is totally doable. It has labeled my x-axis with type of soap, and that's what I wanted, but I don't have a label on my y-axis, so I need to go do that. So over here on the menu, the chart editor, I'm on Customize, and I'm looking at Chart and Axis Titles. The horizontal axis is already labeled. I want the vertical axis, though, the one that goes up and down. Now I can type into this box, and this would be bubble size. And on a graph, in order to add our units, we have to put it into our label. So it looks like I'm measuring the bubble size in centimeters. So I'm going to put that in parentheses, and now I've got everything that I need on this graph. So I'm just going to scooch that to the side. The other graph that we need to do is an averages graph. I've left you a note here to give you a reminder of how to do this. I oftentimes see people just highlight the averages and do an insert chart. If you do that, the computer is not going to know how to label things. So we need to get a way to get all these soaps next to all the averages. Well, that means we need to make a brand new table. So I'm going to do Control C and copy all of my types of soap. And I'm going to paste those down right here. Now over for averages. If I do a Control C and paste those, look what happens. All of a sudden I've got these error messages. And that's because in these boxes, I used my formula. And so when I copy and paste it, the computer's still trying to do the formula down here, which is a problem. So I'm going to undo that. In order to get around this, I'm going to go back. I'm going to do Control C again. I've just copied. But now here's the trick. I'm going to highlight the boxes where I'm going to paste this, but instead of doing Control V to paste, I'm going to right click on your Chromebook, that's two fingers to click, and I'm going to go to Paste Special, and I'm going to tell the computer to just paste the values only. That means don't do the formula, just do the numbers. Now it's given me a lot of decimal places, and that's fine, because I'm never going to use this table. I'm going to throw this away when I'm done. I'm just making it so that I can make a graph. Now I've got something that I can highlight all of those boxes. I'm going to go to Insert, Chart. Make sure that my computer has chosen the right graph type, and I'm still using soap as my IV, which is a qualitative variable. So I'm using bar graph, so that's good. And just like before, I'm going to check off all the things. So my title, I chose average versus soap type. That's not quite good enough. So I'm going to do average bubble size versus type of soap. That's a much better title. Over on my y-axis, if I click here, I think it'll let me start typing. Yep. This would be my bubble size. Remember, that's in centimeters. I'm putting my units in. And it has chosen type of soap for me. Now my graphs are complete.